great can
be. Just want you to believe God and know that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can ask or think.
Break every
chain. He said, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in heavenly places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, glory to God to stand. So what God has anointed his people to do, we as Christians, we as believers, we are called to bind the activity of Satan and to set the captives free. Glory to God. Praise the Lord. I thank God for this broadcast today. Thank you for tuning in to Setting the Captives Free broadcast. Amen. I'm excited today about the Word of God. I'm excited about what God is doing in this last hour. Amen. How many of you know that God did send his son Jesus to set the captives free? Free in every area of our lives, spirit, soul, and body. God wants us to be free. Not only did Jesus come to set the captives free, he gave us the power to maintain our freedom. Amen. So I thank God today for freedom. Glory to God. We don't have to be bound. We don't have to be held captive in Satan's prison. So I thank God for you today. I thank God that you saw fit today to join us on this broadcast, Setting the Captives Free. I am your host, Evangelist Savannah Spears. And just before we go off into our message, I want to go briefly into the throne room and just thank God for his mercy and his grace today, his long suffering, his patience, his goodness, and his kindness. Thank God for his faithfulness on today. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you this morning thanking you for this day. God, we give you the praise, we give you the honor, we give you glory, because you alone are worth it. There is no other God. We thank and praise you today, Father God, that you are the only true and living God. We thank you and praise you today for your mercy and your grace, for all that you've done, for all that you are doing, and for all that you are going to do. Thank you, Father God, that you sent your only son, Jesus, to set the captives free. I thank you today, Father God, that we as believers will endeavor to walk in our God-given authority, that we will walk in the power that you have given us to maintain that freedom. We give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory, and we call it done by faith in Jesus' name. Glory to God. You know, as we embark upon a new year 2019, my desire is that we are getting ourselves prepared, not only for Christmas, not only for the new year, but we are getting ourselves prepared for the coming of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You know, it's so important that we be prepared for the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You know, it's not enough for us to just be preparing for Christmas and be preparing for the new year. Some of us are making preparation for new year resolutions, amen, that many of us will not be able to keep. But I want you to keep in mind today the importance of preparation for our souls, amen. So as we go into our message for today, I want to admonish you to get your Bibles so you can go with me as we journey through the Word of God concerning this message. So our message today is going to be coming from Matthew 25, verses 1 through 13. And we are all familiar with this passage of Scripture because it's dealing with the 10 virgins, the 5 foolish virgins, and the 5 wise virgins. Amen. And so Jesus told this parable to clarify further what it means to be ready for his return and how to live until he comes. See, we must live every day as though Jesus is coming the next moment. Glory to God. And many of us have lost sight on the fact that Jesus is sure to come. We have lost sight on the fact that we are living in the signs of the time, that Jesus is soon to come. We are living these signs every day. Look around us and we see that the fulfillment of prophecy is going forth every day of our lives. And we know from the signs of the time that Jesus is on his way back. So this parable here concerning the five foolish virgins and the five wise virgins teaches us that every person is responsible for his or own spiritual condition. Glory to God. Every person is responsible for securing their souls for eternity. I want you to listen to me closely today, people of God. You know, many times we are so concerned about having car insurance because we want to make sure that if there's an accident or anything happened to our car, our automobile, that we are secured. Amen. But what about our souls? What are we securing our souls for eternity? Do we have life insurance on our souls? You know, it is time now that we begin to prepare for eternity, to secure our souls for eternity. Glory to God. We see in Matthew 16:26, the Bible said, "So what shall it profit a man to gain the whole world and to lose his soul?" Glory to God. What does it make sense for a person to have all kinds of power, to have all kind of control? You know, I use Donald Trump and Bill Gates sometimes as a perfect example, you know, because I pray to God that they don't think that they're going to be standing before God with their checkbooks in their hands, thinking that they can buy God off. You know, we all gonna leave this world one day. We're all going to die one day. And we all gonna have to have that personal relationship with God. Glory to God. And we are all gonna be responsible for where our souls will spend eternity. Glory to God. So this parable also teaches here the importance of being ready for Christ's return in any event. Glory to God. Even if he delays, and he's longer coming than what we expected, we still need to be ready, people of God. We still need to be prepared. No matter when he comes, we ought to be prepared. Glory to God. The truth is, no man knows the day or the hour wherein the Son of Man cometh. You know, this alone should motivate us to be prepared for his coming, because we never know when he's coming. Amen. Are you prepared today? The Bible explicitly states that he's coming as a thief in the night. And we know thieves don't warn their victim as to when they are coming. You know, burglars don't go out and put a notice in the homeowner's mailbox or on their door telling them exactly what time they are going to show up, what time they are going to come and break in. Amen. They come there unexpectedly. And this is how Jesus is coming. He's coming unexpectedly. That's before he said, "Be ye also ready." We got to be ready. We need to be prepared every day of our lives that God give us an opportunity to wake up in the morning. We need to ask ourselves, where will my soul spend eternity? We need to ask ourselves, am I prepared? If Jesus would split those skies today, am I prepared to go back with him? Glory to God. So, when Jesus does come, the sad news is, and this is really sad news, that when Jesus does come, there will be no second chance for the unprepared. Glory to God. We will not be given a second chance. This is why it's so important that we are prepared today. We are prepared now. Jesus could come back any moment. The rapture could take place any moment. Are we prepared? Glory to God. In this parable also, we see here that they all needed light so that all could travel back to the bridegroom's house for the wedding feast. Glory to God. Everyone was required to carry his or her own lamp. So we are responsible for the security of our own souls. This thing is so personal, people of God. We got to have our own personal relationship with God because we are all responsible for our own soul. We will not be able to stand before God and make excuses. We will not be able to stand. I want you to hear me good today. Glory to God, because time is winding up, people of God. And none of us will be able to stand before God, make excuses, and blame someone else for the condition of our souls. Blame someone else that we were not prepared. Because God expects us all to do whatever is necessary to get prepared. This is why God has given us ample time. When we wake up in the morning, this day is for us to prepare ourselves for eternity. This day is to ask the question, if Jesus will come back here today, where will my soul spend eternity? That's why he gave us this opportunity. That's why he gave us this chance. Don't take any day for granted, people of God. Don't take time for granted. Time is a very precious commodity. Glory to God. And there is no time to waste time. Glory to God. If we are not prepared, we need to begin to prepare ourselves for the second coming of Jesus Christ. And just like today, there were those who were prepared and those who were not. And it was the foolish bridesmaids that were not prepared. It was the foolish bridesmaids who had laid down without having any extra oil in their lamps. It was the foolish bridesmaids who were not prepared for the bridegroom. Glory to God. It was foolish for them not to be prepared. And they knew that the bridegroom was coming, but they failed to prepare themselves. Glory to God. They knew he was coming. The foolish had not taken the time to fill their lamps. They had not. What are you doing with God's time? What are you doing? Are you wasting God's time? Are you wasting the time that God has given us to prepare ourselves for his coming? Glory to God. They had not filled their lamps with oil before lying down and falling asleep, not realizing that if their lamps went out, they would not be able to light them again. Glory to God. In this situation, there will be no second chance. Glory to God. If we are not prepared when Jesus come back to get us and take us back home in the rapture, there will be no second chances, people of God. I want you to think about this and think about this strongly. Think about this sincerely. If Jesus will come back today, there will be no time for you to get prepared. Glory to God. There may not even be time for you to repent. Glory to God. It is time now for us to prepare ourselves. The Bible tells us here in 1 Corinthians 15:52, he said that he's coming back in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. Glory to God. How long does it take a person to blink their eyes? But this is how fast the rapture is going to take place. This is how fast Jesus is coming and catch us up and take us up out of here. You know, I think about this so often, you know, because it grieves me to see how people are living. It grieves my soul to see how the body of Christ is living. We are not preparing ourselves. We are not ready. We are not rapture ready. It grieves, it should grieve the body of Christ. It should grieve the remnant to see how people are still walking on the broad and wide way that leads to destruction. They are still engaging themselves in the foolish things of this world. They have walked off from the straight and narrow path that leads to eternal life. They are not willing to pay the cost for discipleship. And we can see that they are doomed for hell. We can see that their souls are in darkness. And it's a grievous thing to see how the body of Christ is living in this last hour. And I believe that it's a deception of the enemy. You know, many times the enemy will deceive us into thinking that we're okay. Sometimes the devil will even fool us into thinking that we have that relationship with God. We can know that we are walking contrary to the word of God. We can know that we are out of compliance to the word of God. We can know that we are not living a holy, a sanctified, and a righteous life because we know what all these things involve. But at the same time, the devil will deceive us into thinking that we are all right in God's eyes. The devil will deceive us into thinking that all we have to do is confess our sins. But let me tell you something. We have to realize, people of God, that sin always carries consequences. So even when we confess our sins, sure, God will forgive us because he is a forgiving God. Oh, I feel this thing by the power of God today. We will confess our sins. God will forgive us of our sins. But at the same time, what the devil failed to tell us that there are still consequences because the Bible said that the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life. So even after we have confessed our sins and we have been forgiven for our sins, there are still consequences that we have to pay for our sins. I think so often about David. How David went against God. How David sinned against God with Bathsheba. And David repented of his sin because the Bible said that he was a man after God's own heart. He was quick to repent of his sin. And God forgave David for his sins. But at the same time, David had to suffer the consequences for his sin. And this is the one thing that the devil would not, the devil always show us the bait, but he never shows us the hook behind the bait. Amen. So in the situation with David, the sword never departed from David's house. Because you know what? Even after God had forgiven him, I want you to think about this and think about this very careful. When we commit sins, when we are living our lives contrary to the word of God, and the devil tells us, deceive us into thinking, well, all you have to do, remember John 1:9, if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Yes, God is a just God. God is a forgiving God. But I tell you, God will never compromise his word. So even after God has forgiven you for your sin, whatever it was that you've done, remember, you still got to pay the penalty for that sin. And this is the one thing that the devil does not want us to realize, that there's always a penalty for sin. Amen. So that when we have an opportunity to live right, we should take advantage of that opportunity. God has given us his word. He's given us a roadmap to follow. He's given us instructions in his word as to how he wants us to live. And it's up to us to follow those instructions. Amen. We have the Holy Spirit living, abiding on the inside of us to help us to carry out those instructions, to help us to live a holy and a sanctified life. Amen. That's why God sent the Holy Spirit. He sent the Holy Spirit to help us to walk upright. One of the jobs of the Holy Spirit, one of the ministries of the Holy Spirit, is to convict us when we go astray. Glory to God. The Holy Spirit is right there to bring us back in check, to put us in check. So don't override when the Holy Spirit come in and check us. Don't override the promptings of the Holy Spirit, the convicting power of the Holy Spirit. He's there to keep us on track. Glory to God. He's there to keep us and to make sure that we are prepared for the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Glory to God. So if the rapture should take place today, people, there would be no time to prepare ourselves to return with Jesus. Think about it. Are you rapture ready? Are you ready to go back at this very instant if Jesus would come? Are you rapture ready? Where would your soul spend eternity? The wise bridesmaids had brought along extra oil in their lamps. See, we got to be prayed up. We got to be fasted up if we are going to be caught up. Glory to God. If we expect to be caught up, we got to be prayed up. We got to be ready. Glory to God. And it's going to take some preparation. Glory to God. We can't take this thing lightly, people of God. We cannot take the word of God lightly. We can't take our lives lightly. We can't take our souls lightly. We have to secure our souls. Glory to God. So at midnight, the Bible said that at midnight, guess what? That it was a time that they least expected. They didn't expect Jesus to come back, or they didn't expect the bridegroom to come back at midnight. As a matter of fact, they laid down not knowing when he was going to arrive. Glory to God. And they laid down unprepared. How many of us are laying down, slumbering and sleeping, unprepared? There's no extra oil in our lamps. We don't have any extra fire. We are not prayed up. We are not fasted up. We are not righteous. We are not living that holy and that righteous life that God requires for us to live. That's having our lamps trimmed and with light and ready, burning. Glory to God. And the Bible said that there was a loud cry at midnight. There was a loud cry. Behold, the bridegroom coming. Go ye out to meet him. Glory to God. And you know, everybody jumped up. The wise jumped up. The foolish jumped up. with their lamps prepared, thinking that they were prepared. But some were prepared and some were not. So they got up, prepared their lamps in anticipation of going back with the bridegroom. My God, my God, my God. I tell you today, people of God, it is time for us to prepare ourselves. It is time for us to prepare our souls for eternity. I tell you, look around you. There's no time to play Russian roulette with our souls. Look at the signs of the time all around. The Bible declares that in the last days that there will be gross violence that will fill the earth. Look around you. There's so much violence. It makes us think about the days of Noah, when God said to Noah, build this ark. Build this ark because the flood is coming. The flood is, but people didn't pay him any attention. As Noah built that ark, people was walking past. I can imagine that how people were just walking past him, thinking that he was foolish, thinking that he hadn't heard from God. They took everything for granted. They took their lifestyles for granted. But guess what? One day, it began to rain, and God did just what he had promised. Glory to God. And we can see the signs of the time all around us. Watch the news. You will see the signs of the time all around us. Mothers and fathers are killing their children. Children are killing their parents. I tell you, we're living. America is living in a sad day. And we need to be ready. We need to prepare ourselves. Prepare ourselves through prayer and fasting. Many of us are praying, but we are not living the life that God expects us to live. Therefore, God is not answering our prayers. He's not hearing our prayers. Glory to God. So it is time for us to begin to line our lives up, people of God, with the word of God and begin to do things God's way. Because just as sure as he promised us that he's coming, he's coming. He's given us all the signs that leads up to his coming. Pay attention. Don't be blinded by the enemy. Open up your spiritual eyes and begin to see what's going on around you. These are the last days. We're living in the last of the last days. Glory to God. So the Bible said that suddenly the foolish bridesmaids realized that their lamps had gone out, which resulted in them running around frantically, trying to desperately borrow oil from the wise. My God, what a predicament to be in. What a sad place to be. When we wake up from our slumber, when we wake up from living our lives like the devil, when we wake up and realize that surely the word of God was true, and we running around frantically, trying to borrow oil from somebody who is already prepared. My God, my God. What a sad time. What a sad time. You listen to what the wise said to them. He said, the wise explained to them, we don't have enough to spare. We don't have enough oil to share. Someone might say, how selfish. But it wasn't selfish. This was not selfish. The wise bridesmaids realized that if they shared their little oil, then all the torches would burn low and there wouldn't be enough light for the wedding procession. My God, my God. This is why God has given us every time to prepare our own lamps. You know, we have lamps. They all had lamps. They all were responsible for keeping extra oil in their own lamps. People of God, we are responsible for the condition and the welfare of our own souls. You will not be able to blame your pastor. You will not be able to blame your prayer partner. We are responsible for the security of our own souls. Jesus focused on the foolish people. Unpreparedness. Unpreparedness. We can look all around us in the body of Christ. We see the things that's going on right now in the body of Christ. And it shows that there is such an unpreparedness for the coming of Jesus. Such an unpreparedness. All kind of corruption, all kind of wickedness, all kind of evil, all kind of immorality that's going on right in the body of Christ, indicating that this is a season of unpreparedness. People are not prepared for the coming of Jesus Christ. So when Jesus returns to take his people to heaven, we got to be ready. Spiritual preparation cannot be bought or borrowed. I'm going to say that again. Spiritual preparation cannot be bought, and it cannot be borrowed. Not at the last minute. No one can rely on anyone else. My God, we would not be able to rely on anyone else. Glory to God. People, I tell you, there's a remnant that's trying to make it. Remember what Peter said at his first message after Pentecost. Save yourselves from this untoward generation. It's time now for us to begin to take inventory of our own lives and see what condition our own lives are in. Glory to God. And there will be no oil for us to spare, no oil for us to share for those who have ignorantly, foolishly laid down and went to sleep with no extra oil in their lamps. Glory to God. Our relationship with God has got to be our own. We have to have our own relationship with God, people of God. This thing is so personal. Sadly, while the foolish bridesmaids were out trying to buy oil, guess what? The bridegroom came. Everyone proceeded onto the wedding banquet. And guess what? The foolish was left behind. My God, my God. That I'm telling you, it is enough to grieve our very souls just to think how the foolish had been left behind because they had failed to prepare themselves for the coming of the bridegroom. I tell you today, people of God, the bridegroom is coming. And he's coming for a church, a prepared church. He's coming for a church without spot or wrinkle. He's coming for a church whose robes have been washed and made white in the blood of the Lamb. He is coming, but he's coming for a prepared church. Glory to God. The Bible said that the door was locked. No one could enter because it was too late. My God, it was too late. And no one could enter after the door was locked. I believe that Jesus' point here is that to not be ready at the right time means to miss out completely. There was no time for them to prepare. I want you to think about that today, people of God. If we miss out, there will be no second chance. There will be no time for us to prepare. Glory to God. The finality of the shutting of the door, those outside would not have another chance to be let in. So my question to you today, as I close this message, which one of these categories are you in? Which one? The wise or the foolish? I pray today that you are among the wise who have extra oil in your lamp, who is ready, who is prepared for the coming of the bridegroom. For truly, he's coming back. Just as he promised. Glory to God. My prayer today is that if you are not prepared, you need to get yourself prepared. For Jesus is coming, and he's coming soon. Thank you once again for tuning in to Setting the Captives Free broadcast. I pray that you have a very merry Christmas, and don't forget the reason for the season. God bless you.
Break every chain. Woo! To break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain. There is power.
Come on.
In the name of Jesus.
Come on, you declare it.
There is power.
God bless you, and thank you once again for watching Setting the Captives Free broadcast. I'm your host, Evangelist Savannah Spears. God bless you.
Break every chain. Break every chain.
Come on, say it to me.
Break every chain. Break every chain.
What's up, everybody? This is your girl, Vicki Winans, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
My name is Mike Duggan, and I'm watching the Bell Global Network.
Hey, keep it locked. It's your boy, D. Hattie, watching the Bell Global Network. You know how it is.
Hi, I'm Charlie Langton, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, this is Martha Reeves, and you're watching Bell Global Network.
Hi, everybody. I'm telling you, everything that happened to me that was good, God did it. I'm Evelyn Turrentine, AG, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Pastor D. Alexander Bullock, the Preachers of Detroit, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
This is Bishop Edgar Vann of Second Ebenezer Church in Detroit, Michigan, and you're watching the Bell Global Network.
Hi, I'm Bernadette Stannis. You know me best as Thelma from the TV show Good Times, and you are watching Bell Global Network.